I'm Victoria Halcomb. I am the Victims Advocate at the Kentucky River Child Advocacy Center. Most people know us as the Care Cottage. That's what we're known around town. We do forensic interviewing and medical exams on children that have been severely physically abused and sexually abused. Anytime a referral is called in to social services or law enforcement for either of those referrals come to us, and we have specially trained forensic interviewers who have had an extra 40-hour training on top of their master's degree to be able to talk to these kids so that it is admissible in court, so that they can, law enforcement and social workers can get the prosecution that needs to be done for these kids. Sometimes with either sexual or physical abuse, we need a medical exam. And so we do medical exams here on campus as well, so that it's in a non-threatening environment. The kids don't feel scared because they're not going to a hospital or a clinic. So our Dr. Robin Whitaker comes over to us usually every Friday is when we do our medical exams. And if there's evidence, then we need to take pictures of those so that it can be used in court later for prosecution. We'd really like to thank the Kentucky Colonels for being willing to give us the grant this year for our Cortex Flow machine. This is the Cortex Flow. It is a very, very developed piece of equipment. We have the camera that has the full circle of light around it so that we can see what we need to see, whether it's in a sexual abuse case or severe physical. With a severe physical, sometimes if you get them a couple days later, the bruising has faded. But with this technology, we can see the bruising that has faded by using a different light exposure, so that we can see the bruising and they can still make those findings that they need to, that we may not have been able to see before. So this equipment that we've been able to purchase through the Kentucky Colonel grant is going to be a huge game changer in our Eastern Kentucky River region for the 8 counties that we cover. Once again, we can't thank the Kentucky Colonels enough for what they've done for us.